Please get ready for transcription number 146 and 147. 5 seconds. Start. Now, sir, when the 10th five-year plan was under discussion, I happened to be a member of the Committee of Parliament, which was dealing with resources, and I happened to belong to that school which thought that the target of the 7th five-year plan was too much big for our resources, internal as well as external, and the alternative that I, along with others who agreed with me, suggested was that we should fix a series of priorities and cut down those which were non-essential, and that in the alternative, we should extend the period of the plan to 6 years or 7 years. Parliament, after debating the whole issue, unanimously agreed in both the houses that the targets of the 10th five-year plan, as laid down by the Planning Commission, should be carried out. When Parliament came to that decision, it had before it the minute of dissent written by Professor Rao as well as by one of the members of the Planning Commission. Both these gentlemen had also warned that the target of the plan was much too big for the resources of this country. However, Parliament took that decision, and after that decision, we had a general election in the country. The 10th five-year plan was before the country, and the country, by an overwhelming majority, approved the plan and returned this party in greater numbers in the Lok Sabha this time than was the case last time. Therefore, it is too late in the day to ask the finance minister or the government of India to scale down the targets of the 10th five-year plan. We as a people and also as a parliament are now committed to the execution of this plan, wherein a target of ₹48,000 crores was fixed. It is now, I believe, increased to ₹52,000 crores or ₹54,000 crores. Now, when we have agreed on that basic point, then we must find the resources to implement that plan. For some time, we had also debated the question of deficit financing, which, of course, is a euphemism in modern parlance for the printing of notes. When we need money, we issue treasury bills, and notes are issued by the Reserve Bank. This sort of thing cannot continue forever. We must be prepared to make whatever sacrifices are needed to implement the 10th plan. Therefore, I submit, starting with these two assumptions, namely that the plan target has got to be implemented, and secondly, the deficit financing has got to be avoided, both in the interests of the economy as well as of progress. We are left with only one option, viz. To impose taxes. I know that our present finance minister, Dr. Manmohan Singh, is a man of conviction, and what is more important, has the courage of his conviction. That is why I think, in living memory, he is the one finance minister, who has come out with this bold and courageous plan of imposing taxation to the tune of rupees 1000 crores in one single year. To impose tax of the dimension of rupees 1000 crores in one single year requires tremendous courage, and I must congratulate him for the step that he has taken, because it was the least that any finance minister could do, faced as he was with the circumstances which I have just narrated. With the imposition of these taxes, the uncovered deficit dwindles down from rupees 500 crores. That itself is a great help. I believe the government should take immediate steps. When we are taking very drastic measures to tax every sector of society, from the rich to the poor, it becomes a duty, in fact, a trust, that the money that we raise is spent as carefully and as economically as possible. In the general elections, I too had, along with other honorable members of our party and other parties also, to go into the country, to the villages and towns and everywhere. The people did not mind these taxes, but the grievance is that some of the money, or a lot of money, is being wasted. There was the grievance with regard to corruption on the lower levels of the officialdom, and what is more, that there was considerable wastage. Every official, even a small official, seems to be having a jeep or a Maruti and is running about burning petrol and spending on TA, DA, etc., and the work is being rushed through in the months of February and March in order that the grant may not lapse, as if the taxpayers' money were meant to be sacrificed ruthlessly and mercilessly, whatever happens. Therefore, it becomes necessary for the government, both at the center and in the states, at all levels, to see that all the money raised and spent in these plants is fully utilized. One of the serious problems which has been dealt with is the food situation in the country. The president's address very rightly remarked that though it is not alarming, still it is serious. It is of grave concern. The economy in the country is also not very safe. All these are stark realities which the country and the leaders of society, as we are in this August House, will have to face. This August House, and also the several houses in the states, have given their approval to the 10th five-year plan. It has been approved and it is already working, though its first year of progress may be very slow, and several reasons beyond the control of the Government of India. However, the food situation in the country indicates, as the statistics given by the Ministry of Agriculture show that there is a steady increase in the production, and as such they have sounded a note of cautious optimism. Stop.